Would you like to be able to record the downloaded transactions and apply them to customer invoices and vendors' bills? Well, you can do that after watching this video. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. QuickBooks Bank Feeds is so great, you can actually apply the downloaded deposits to customers' invoices and the downloaded checks and expenses to vendors' bills. Downloaded deposits can be applied to customer and job invoices, and download checks and expenses can be applied to any vendor unpaid bill. It does not matter if the downloaded check or deposit was recorded before or after the bill or the invoice. With the new interface in the QuickBooks Online Bank Feeds, it's very simple to record and apply. And we will do four examples. We will do two examples of deposits applied to invoice, one before the invoice is recorded and one after. Then we'll do two examples of downloaded checks, one applied to the bill before the bill was recorded and one after. This proves that they're basically the same and it does not matter the order that they were downloaded. So what are the steps for applying downloaded deposits to open invoices? Well, first, when you record it from the Bank Feed Center, the account category that you choose is accounts receivable. Then you put the customer's name in the payee field, which is really the name field. QuickBooks will generate a credit for that customer or job that you will be able to see in the customer reports. And then you leave the Bank Feeds window and go to the Receive Payments window to apply that recorded deposit that you just recorded from Bank Feeds to any open invoice. First example, we will apply a downloaded deposit to an existing invoice. Greta Garbage has two open invoices for $100 each. We will apply the deposit from April 8th for $150 to all of the oldest invoice and some of the second for Greta Garbage. Now, remember these are the steps and this is what we'll do. And the date was April 8th for $150. Okay. So, we go to banking, we go to the Bank Feed Center, and we scroll to the April 8th, this one's open, let's close it. We scroll to the April 8th transaction, which is right here. April 8th, click the check mark. Now, we have to choose the right account, the proper account category, if it's being applied to a customer's invoice, is accounts receivable. So scroll carefully until you find accounts receivable and click on it. Now the customer is Greta Garbage. So we are now applying this $150 to her balance. And if we click Add, we can then click Reports. Custom reports, transaction list by customer, and we go down to Greta Garbage, and we can see that she has two open invoices that no payments have been applied to, and she has this deposit. I have to scroll to the right for you to see the money amounts, but these are the two open invoices, and this was the deposit that we just recorded. Now, the last step requires that we go to the Receive Payments window to apply the deposit to the invoices. So we click New, Receive Payment. Of course, we choose Greta Garbage, And when we choose her, we see the two invoices on top and whatever credits she might have on the bottom. Now notice QuickBooks automatically applied this deposit to these invoices. But we learned in other courses that you can apply them how you want by removing the check marks and putting the proper money amounts in. Basically, it's right. $150 is paying off all of the first invoice and some of the second invoice. You could switch it. You could remove the check marks and you could apply $50 to the newer one and apply $100 to the other one, but the total must equal the deposit that you're using down here or the transaction won't record. Click Save and Close, and now you can check the Open Invoice Report. Reports, Open Invoice, and when you go to Greta Garbage, she only has one remaining open invoice in the amount of $50. Now in our second example, it will be very similar, except the transactions will be in the opposite order. We record the deposit as a credit to the customer's account and make the invoice after. The deposit from Candy Charles on March 21 is a down payment from customer Candy Charles in the amount of $2,400, and it is for a future carpentry job. So, it's the exact same thing in a different order, and we'll remember first we put in the accounts receivable account, we put in the customer's name, and we generate a credit. Then, after that, we make the invoice and go to the receive payments window. But right now, let's back up a little. We want to record the $2,400 on March 21 as a credit to Candy, and then we're going to make the invoice after. No problem. We go to the banking section here, and we go to March 21. It's in date order, thank God. Here it is. Now, we want to make sure that we handle this properly, so we click here, and instead of uncategorized income, again we learned, if it's going to be applied to a future invoice or even a past invoice, we choose accounts receivable as the account category. And of course, we have to choose the right customer, Candy Charles. And that's all we have to do in this window. And then of course, we click Add. And we'll double check that this created a credit for Candy. Reports, transaction list by customer, and then you see Candy Charles. Candy Charles has just this deposit that's money paid in advance for the two invoices. Now, what we will do after, you see, we did these three steps, and now in this same example, we'll imagine on April 10th, we did $5,000 of carpentry for Candy, and we'll apply the $2,400. So we click New, Invoice, and we choose the customer that paid us in advance. And then the date was whatever the date was in this example, April 10. And we did carpentry. But most importantly, the money amount in our example is the most important piece of data, $5,000 for Candy. Now we click Save and Close, and now when we go back to the customer report, transaction list by customer, you can see that these still are two separate transactions for Candy Charles. There's a deposit and then there's an invoice. Now this payment gets generated automatically. It's created by QuickBooks Online to automatically apply payments to deposits. And we double click and we can see it actually did step four for us. The only thing we have to be careful of is if we don't agree how QuickBooks applied the customer's payments. In other words, if Candy had five invoices and the money amount from the deposit didn't cover it, then if QuickBooks applied it to the wrong invoice, we would remove the check mark and place it again on the ones that we wanted and type in the money amounts, just like we did in the basic introductory course. But when we save this and we click yes, something's not quite right here. You can't apply more than the payments that you put the check mark on. So you might have several credits, but only one check mark is on 2400, so the most you can apply in the top part is 2400. And when you save and close, and you go back to the open invoice report, reports, open invoice, because that's the one that shows how the payments and the invoices were applied, you see that what remains for Candy is the difference between the $5,000 invoice and the $2,400 deposit that was downloaded, because we applied them together in the receive payments window. And just like QuickBooks can handle prepayments from customers for income, it can handle advance payments to vendors for future bills that we will receive. The steps are exactly the same, except with the vendor-related words. When you record the check or the expense from the bank feed center into your records, you will choose the accounts payable account as the account category. Then put the vendor's name in the payee field, and then QuickBooks will generate a credit for that vendor that we can check on the vendor reports. Then use the repay bills, that's a little typo, it's the pay bills window to apply the payments. It's not repay bills, it's just pay bills. Watch. In our third example, we apply downloaded checks to an existing bill. Peter Perfect is a vendor that we have two unpaid bills with. We will apply the checks from March 23rd, 2017. Okay, March 23rd, 2017, and these are the steps. So, very simple. We go to the banking center, and we go down to March 23rd. This is it, right here, boom. This March 23rd is going to be applied to the thing. Don't worry that it says Betty. We're going to fix that. Click here, and of course the category must be accounts payable. Accounts payable. And the vendor is Peter Perfect. And the amount is already set up here, the amount that's downloaded and the date, and click add. And now when we click reports, and we click transaction list by vendor, you can see that Peter Perfect has two unpaid bills and an expense, a payment, which it decreases what we owe. So we owe for the bills and we owe a little less for this payment. The best report really is the unpaid bills report in the standard area. If you go who you owe, unpaid bill. Now, save customization so that it stays in the custom area, but look at Peter Perfect. His balance is $1,100 because he has two invoices and one payment, but they have not yet been applied together. So what do we do? We do step four. We use the pay bills window. No problem. New, and we go to vendors, pay bills. The pay bills window looks very similar to the receive payment window, except the credits are not as apparent. In the pay bills window, in order to see the credits available, you have to click the check mark, and QuickBooks will suggest and reveal the credit available. So if we apply the whole $1,400 to this $1,500 outstanding bill, it means this $1,000 will still be here, but the first bill will only be open by a $100 amount. And we're not paying $100, we're just applying a credit. So make the payment amount zero and the credit applied $1,400. The pay bills window is not exactly as smooth as the receive payments window. In order to see the credits for vendors, you have to click a check mark first. So don't worry, we can now click save and close, And now when we go back to reports, custom, unpaid bills, you see that for Peter Perfect, the first bill was $1,500, now it's down to $100, and you can see the second bill is untouched. Now, in our fourth example, we're going to record the downloaded payment before we actually get the service and enter the bill. So let's imagine that the May 2nd, 1200, that was a payment that was downloaded, goes to Penelope Pit Stop, and it is in advance of the bills that we will receive. And we will record the payment first from the review list. Okay, so let's record this from the review list May 2nd. So we click Banking, and we go down to the May 2nd, and here we find the May 2nd $1,200. Click on the account category, and it'll open it up and let you change it. And now we want to choose the proper vendor, Penelope Pit Stop, and we want to choose the right account, and of course, we now know the right account for payments for bills is accounts payable. Now, all we have to do is click Add, and when we click Reports, Unpaid Bills, we can see Penelope Pit Stop has a prepayment. She paid in advance, that's why the number is negative on the unpaid bills report. Now, we receive bill number 98765 from Penelope for equipment rental expense, and we did that, we got that bill on June 12th of 2022 in the amount of $3,000. So, let's enter the bill and then apply the payment that we just recorded from the bank feeds. We click New, Vendor Bill. The date we said was June 12th. It was a bill from Penelope Pit Stop in the category of equipment rental. Equipment rental expense, don't worry about the pop-ups, and the bill number was 98765, and the amount was $3,000. So now we click Save and Close, and when we look at the unpaid bill report, we see both things in Penelope Pit Stop's section of the unpaid bills, but there should only be one. They have to be netted together, and the way to net them together is to click New, Vendor, Pay Bills, and when we choose Penelope Pit Stop right here, we click here and we get her category, New, Pay Bills. See, these are all the unpaid bills that we could pay, but we want to just pay Penelope Pit Stop. So we're going to click here, and then notice the credits appear. The only way to know the credit is to click and see what credit is available. And QuickBooks also assumes we're paying the rest of the bill, so since we're not, since we're only applying the credit, make the payment column become zero. Now, save and close, and the unpaid bill report shows that this bill that was originally $3,000 now only has an unpaid bill amount of $1,800. And that's how you apply bank feeds to invoices and bills.